In 1508, Italy gave birth to Andrea Palladio, one of the most innovative original architects in Renaissance Italy. Palladio was born in Padua, but Vicenza was his adoptive city, which proved to be most conducive to his creativity. It stands to reason that French historian Louis Courayeau described Vicenza as a place blessed by heaven and one of those nests prepared by nature for the birth of art. Palladio, whose career began as an unassuming mason, became perhaps the most influential architect in history. His subtle use of proportions, his sense of how a house should fit its setting, his delight in columns, pilasters, and pediments formed the language of Western architecture until almost the modern age. The villas he designed in the countryside around Venice are among the most beautiful houses ever built. But they are not just exercises in pure form. They were intended to express the ideals of reason, humanity, and civilization in Renaissance life, and to provide practical settings from which the sophisticated merchants or gentry from Vicenza and Venice could exercise their privileges as landowners and their responsibilities as farmers. With regard to Ireland, quite a few mansions were inspired by Palladio. To share the momentum of this fifth centenary of his birth is the Honourable Desmond Guinness, founder of the Irish Georgian Society and co-author of a book entitled Palladio, A Western Progress.
Well, this is a book about Andrea Palladio and his extraordinary influence over the whole world, whether it's America, Russia, Ireland, England. He was, for a certain time, the master. And it's a great privilege to be here today to share something about him, which I hope that we will all keep forever in our thoughts.
Dotted around Ireland are examples of historical buildings and mansions which are a testimony of Palladio's influence. Castletown House in County Kildare was built in 1722 by Sir Edward Lowett Piers, an Irish architect who had been to Italy and was imbued with Palladian ideas. Similar influence can be seen in Carton House, which was remodeled and enlarged by German architect Richard Castle in 1739. The same architect, Richard Castle, built Powerscourt House in County Wicklow in 1731 for the Wingfield family. Rusborough House in Blessington, County Wicklow, is the jewel in the crown of all Richard Castle's houses, and the best preserved, with every original feature still intact. It was built in 1741 for Joseph Leeson, 1st Earl of Milltown. Last but not least, a fine example of distinct Palladian influence is Lucan House in County Dublin, the official residence of the Italian ambassador to Ireland. Lucan is a pure Palladian villa built in 1722 by Agmodician Vese on the site of an early building. The exquisite elegance of its design, both inside and outside, is a credit to what Palladio stood for. In 2005, a book was published by the Honourable Desmond Guinness on Lucan House, commissioned by the Italian ambassador. Thank you. Andrea Palladio, with his unique, exquisite sense of architectural proportions and elegance, was and still is, till now, an inspiration to those who wish to add splendor and grandeur to their buildings, be they stately homes, mansions, or private villas. His legacy to the world is unsurpassed. In 1979, famous theatre and film director Joseph Losey filmed Mozart's opera Don Giovanni. He chose Palladio's Rotonda as the setting for his unique production. Here are some scenes of the first act of the opera.
Non voglio, e